me Rahul, and on today's Android Tips episode, I will show you guys how to install or flash a custom ROM and how to install a custom kernel. Two are very simple things to do once you understand the basics. By the way, if you guys want to see any particular how-tos or tutorial on any tweaks, just comment down below. Since this is going to be a short video, I will explain a bit about custom kernels and custom ROMs. ROMs are basically the OS or the operating system of the phone. There are two kinds of ROM. One is called stock ROM. It is the version of the OS that comes with the phone when you buy it, and it is developed by the manufacturer itself. Custom ROM, on the other hand, is a bit different than stock ROMs. Custom ROMs are developed by independent developers. The difference between these two is, with custom ROMs, you will get a lot of features. You will get good performance, better UI, and you can upgrade to a version of the OS that has not yet been released for your device. Now let's talk about kernel. Kernel is a part of a device which connects the application, the software part, to the hardware part. Custom kernels have a lot of awesome features like enables swap partition, better battery backup, better performance, and so on. For this video, I'm gonna be using my old phone. Its screen is a bit broken, so bear with me. In order to flash custom ROMs or custom kernels, your device has to be rooted and you must be installed a custom recovery on your phone. If you have no idea about rooting or custom recoveries, then watch this video. First thing that you need to do is you need to find a good ROM for your device. I recommend XDA Forums for finding good ROMs because it's a pretty good website. So open this website, then type in your device name here. Then from here, you need to select Android Development. Then select the ROMs tab for custom ROMs and select kernels tab for custom kernels. Then download a custom ROM including its patch files and a custom kernel that you like. Then copy all the files to your phone, then reboot your device into recovery mode. If you don't know how to boot into recovery mode, just Google it because it differs with the device. I'm using a recovery called CWM Clockwork Mode. I recommend going with Twerp since it is a bit more user-friendly. But anyway, the methods are pretty common. So before you flash custom ROM, you need to wipe data. So in CWM, you simply select wipe data / fact reset. And then you flash custom ROM by selecting install SIP from SD card, choose SIP from SD card, or in case you put the SIP file in the internal storage, select the other option. Choose the ROM SIP file, then just install it. If this ROM has any patch files, install it too. In order to flash the custom kernel, you have to wipe cache and Dalvik cache first, then select install SIP from SD card, choose SIP from SD card, and select the kernel SIP file and install it. I also want to say a few things. Number one is, create a backup of your current ROM before you flash a custom ROM. Number two is, you should always flash kernel after ROM, because if you do it vice versa, the custom kernel will get replaced with the kernel that comes with the ROM. So that's it guys, hope it helps. So that's been it guys, hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, definitely give it a thumbs up, and I will see you guys again. Goodbye.
Swear it's been 700 degrees in here since you came in. I could swear that this room has been running out of air, and now it's starting to spin.